Anti-vaxxer kickboxing champion 41 dies after refusing to accept COVID as dangerous. Kickboxing champion Frederic Sinistra, 41, tried to treat himself at home for the little virus after denying he had COVID and leaving a hospital in Liege, Belgium. An anti-vaxxer kickboxing champion has died after he refused to accept COVID as dangerous and tried to treat himself at home. Frederic Sinistra, 41, discharged himself from a hospital in Liege, Belgium, after denying he had been infected with COVID, which he described as a little virus, the Express reports. But the three-time world champion died with complications relating to the virus in the small Belgian city of Ciney just weeks later. This comes as Boris Johnson is expected to review the data today to decide if England will introduce fresh COVID restrictions. Reports claim the 41-year-old, known as the Undertaker, told his followers on social media he would treat his symptoms away from the hospital. Posts shared to Sinister's Facebook page showed the kickboxing champion, who had a 39-win-9 loss record, lying in bed at an intensive care ward with an oxygen tube in his nose. However, Sinister also posted a video to his 37,000 Facebook followers, in which he seemed to have some difficulty breathing. He added the caption, "No time to waste with lazy people." In other posts, he called COVID the little virus and voiced opposition to the government's measures to halt the spread of coronavirus. Local reports suggest the kickboxer only entered the hospital after being forced to do so by his coach Osman Yijin, 50. Speaking to Belgian news outlet Sud Info, Mr. Yijin claimed he told Sinister he would not train the three-time world champion unless he went to hospital to receive medical attention. Kickboxing World pays tribute to Frederic Sinistra. Sinister won world and European heavyweight kickboxing titles throughout his career, while also claiming a national title in Belgium in 2004. He was 39-win-9 loss record in his professional career and was once branded Belgium's strongest man. Former coach Fabien Pavon was among those to pay tribute to Sinistra, describing him as a force of nature with a heart of gold. Frank Jordan Esferza posted, "He was a golden guy. I will never forget him. He was the strongest in Belgium in the heavyweight category." The Belgian government imposed new measures starting on Sunday that ordered cultural venues like movie theaters and concert halls to close. Some venues defied the ban, and thousands of performers, event organizers, and others demonstrated on Sunday in Brussels against the decision, carrying signs reading "The show must go on" or "No culture, no future." They accused the Belgian government of double standards because it allowed Christmas markets, with their boisterous crowds and mulled wine drinking, to stay open, along with restaurants and bars. Even the scientific committee advising the Belgian government had not asked for the culture industry closures, leaving virologist Mark Van Rans to ponder that, in Belgium, gluing beat culture.